Thank you. Now to the deadly shooting spree that has stunned the nation. Three people are dead after shots rang out three different times in Pine Hills.
The suspected gunman is in jail this morning. He is accused of killing a 9-year-old girl, a local TV reporter, as well as a young woman. WestU's Bob Hazen is live this morning to walk us through what happened. Bob.
Yeah, it is just incredible violence against innocent victims. And the sheriff here in Orange County says even he can't make sense of why any of it happened. Now, I want to show you this picture. This is the 19-year-old man that investigators believe is responsible for all of the killing. 19-year-old Keith Moses. He is in the Orange County jail this morning. We are told this started around 11 in the morning yesterday when Moses allegedly shot and killed a young woman in her car on Hialeah Street in Pine Hills. Now, news crews were out there covering that shooting, and law enforcement wrapped up the scene in the afternoon, then left. Our WestU crew left around the same time, but a reporter and photographer from Spectrum News 13 were still there. Investigators say that is when Moses came up and shot both of them. The young reporter was killed. News 13 this morning confirming that reporter is Dylan Lyons. Then the sheriff says Moses went down the street and opened fire on a mom and a young child as well.
He walks inside the house and shoots the 9-year-old and the mom. And right now we're unclear as to why he shot them in that house. Really unclear as to why he shot at the news vehicle as well.
In jail on one charge of murder, but many more charges are expected to come soon. We're also expecting that Moses will go in front of a judge later on today. Reporting live at the Orange County Sheriff's Office, Bob Hazen, WestU News.
Bob, thank you. The mother of the 9-year-old that was killed in this attack is also in the hospital this morning. WestU's Tony Atkins has spent the morning at Orlando Regional Medical Center. Tony, what's going on there? What's happening?
Well, you know, the sun is coming up and it's an unusual day. You know, obviously for the two people that remain in the hospital, they're in critical condition. But, you know, this should be a day where everyone was supposed to wake up and it should have been a normal day. But instead, it's just a very tragic day for so many people impacted. Over my shoulder, I'm outside ORMC. For much of the morning, there were deputy squad vehicles out. Right now, it's unclear if they're inside at this point, but they have been here continuing their investigation. And just right across the street there, members of the press, local and national, and I've seen a few from across the state of Florida, all here in Orlando reporting with heavy hearts after this, you know, these senseless shootings here. Now, this morning at the hospital, two people are fighting for their lives, a mother as well as a Spectrum News 13 photojournalist, Jesse Walden. Orange County Sheriff John Mina says both are here in critical condition right now. As for Walden, we've learned he is alert and he is talking, but we're still waiting for more information about the mother. Now, I will be here live at the ER all throughout the morning. Updates have been coming in. We do expect to hear more at some point today. And as soon as we get more updates, we'll be sure to have it for you. In the meantime, I'm going to keep an eye on things out here at ORMC. For now, reporting live in Orlando, Tony Atkins, WestU News.
And as the messages of support and prayers pour in this morning, WestU's Meredith McDonough has the words of comfort from local faith leaders across Central Florida who are also speaking out against these tragic shootings.
Sheldon, we spoke with a local pastor and bishop who were both rocked by the deadly shootings yesterday. Pastor Jake Stovall has led marches and called for peace, leading the way after losing his own daughter to gun violence. Like many across Central Florida, he's now trying to wrap his mind around the three lives lost Wednesday.
It was cruel, you know, it's just because of, you know, they didn't do their job and they had nowhere on their minds, on your heart also, when you go to do a report or something, you thinking that you got to be looking all around you or thinking something going to happen to you like that. It's truly an eye-opener for our city.
Stovall has a simple message that he always says after tragedies: put down your guns and pick up your prayer book. We also spoke with an Orlando pastor who has served the Pine Hills community for more than a decade. Bishop Kevin L. Cobaris says the number one thing that happens after violence is heightened fear.
Protect your families by any means necessary. Keep yourself safe. Watch your surroundings. And when you know about things that are happening in this community, this should be enough to let you know that you need to say something about what you see.
He also adds it's going to take all of us to minimize the violence and reduce crime in our community. Sheldon, over to you.
All right, Mayor. And this attack has hit our community very hard, understandably, and West 2 will continue to bring any information on the suspected shooter as the case against.